The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Hey, my nigga.
It's happening, man.
Can you believe they let us on the radio together, man?
Man, look, this is the bootleg version of the 5150 show. We trying to get it back on and cracking.
Man, y'all get ready, man, because this is an honor, man, to have somebody that gave us the opportunity to come on and speak truth to power.
OG Porter's been trying to catch up with me for a while. I do a lot of traveling, but we finally hooked it up, so we're going to start running the 5150 show. Darlene couldn't make it. You know, when the 5150 show shut down, she had to find ways to earn money, and she couldn't shake dude tonight, I guess. But Darlene will be back on the next show, and it's on and cracking.
In the meantime, man, it's me and Corey. I'm the country boy, Bobby Glanton Smith, Corey's oldest friend on the West Coast.
And from what I understand, the cameras are on so y'all can see us. Look, I ain't getting my motherfucking hair cut and it's hot in this motherfucker.
Because he don't have to, man. That nigga famous, man. And I'm in the witness protection program, so let's do this, man.
Anyway, I want my baby mama to know, if you watching this, my daughter's mama, I want you to know that you a lousy bitch. I just wanted to put that out there.
And
you
got
any lousy bitches you want to shout out to? Bobby?
Not really, man, because they still looking for me.
Well, that's the main lousy bitch.
You know my drama, man. Come on, man.
My daughter, mama, I still owe her, according to child support, $1,000. But it's only enforceable if it's $2,000 or more. So this bitch waiting on that $1,000.
Well,
you bum ass bitch.
Man, you in shape, man, because they got brothers, man, living up under the freeway behind that bullshit.
Oh,
man.
I'm already knowing, man. I'm here to tell you. I ain't going to say your name. Lousy bitch, if you waiting on that $1,000, I'm going to give it to you right after Christmas. Well, you owe it all out anyway. You bum ass bitch. I got a text from some motherfucker. Anyway,
already. Okay.
We are a different version of
everything.
What goes on the radio. We are against the grain. I was talking to my friend Bobby here where me and him have similar feelings toward what Barack has done since he's been in the White House. And one thing I could say that we both agree on, you lose a lot of friends in the African-American community if you are bold enough to speak on what Barack doesn't do.
I'm going to tell you how bad it got, man. I had to reach out to Corey, and he ain't really that kind of brother that he want to hear that kind of bullshit if you've ever called him and listened to his messages. But I got so messed up, man. My best friend for 50 years called me a Uncle Tom because I told him that Obama needed to grow some nuts. And he asked me if I was a Republican. Then he called me a Uncle Tom because I said, man, look here, man. That man done had to leave his church, leave his friends, stay away from black people altogether.
You say, what did you say he have against black people?
Oh, man, I sent you that. He got a Negro restraining order against his own people, man.
I get dismissed as ignorant every time I say something about my problems with Barack Obama and what he does as the president of the United States of America.
Is that what he is, man? I thought he was the janitor, man, because I done seen a white woman come up and point her finger in his face like he was, you know, cleaning up the White House. Right. And he didn't sick the Secret Service on that bitch. Right. You know, and I was like, hold up, man. You fucking me up with this bullshit, because that gave, you know, white women and some sisters the right to come up to me and think that they could do that to me, man. I said, look, brother, it'd be one thing if it was just, you know, you doing that. But this done gave folks the nuts to come up to men with this bullshit.
Yeah, yeah. The number to call in is 323-965-1600. I'm learning all this new shit. 323-965-1600. Call in, say something, whether you're with us or against us, because we're going to spend the first hour of this show talking about the Barack debacle.
Because that's what it is for some of us. Because some of us want him to just be a man about it. Because I'll be honest, I couldn't in good conscience vote for Mitt Romney because he wear magic underwear as a part of his religion. And that's part of why I'm upset with Obama, that he ain't pimp slapped somebody for calling him a Muslim after he done killed more Muslims than any president in the history of this country.
That's real. And you know what, people, that fact, you just stated right there, most people who don't want to hear it will say something's wrong with you. Because let me explain something to you. Even though you speak up for people, or of people, there are a lot of them that don't want to be saved because they don't want no trouble, they scared, or they are content with being the janitor. You know what I mean? It's a lot of people out here don't want you to. Oh, why you talking about Barack? He gonna do his thing on the second go round, or y'all just saying that because they don't want. They like it like that. They like being the slave. You know, the house slave that felt good about cleaning up.
And, we sick.
Right. Yeah. But that's a reference like when Master was sick, a lot of the house slaves would be like, "We sick, Master?" Yeah, that type of thing. I get what you're saying.
Then we got our first call, Otis from Texas.
This is our first caller on the 5150 show here at, let me make sure I got this station
RMC
right.
On
RMCOnAir.com.
Man, come on in here, Otis.
What's up, Otis?
Hey, what's going on, man? Corey, how you been?
Hey, man, I ain't got no complaints, man. The bill's paid and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Man, I'm glad you're back on the show because I've been listening to this show for a while. But now I got a question for you. This is touching on a situation that happened while you were gone. What's your thoughts on the Chad Ochocinco debacle?
Well, if anybody knows that young lady got a mouth on her. And she's also said, you know, she got issues. So it's something that happens to a lot of brothers in this country where she did too much. She obviously got in his face because this man doesn't have a history of beating up women like that, even though they tried to bring up some shit that happened back in college. You know what I'm saying? Because most of the time when you get into any type of confrontation with a woman where it turns physical, you did something wrong automatically. So old girl with the big mouth probably got up in his face and she got a... She got her wig split. I heard the bitch a permanent crackhead now.
Well, you know, she was on a...
And she destroyed the home, if you ask me, because he lost his job.
Right.
She ain't going to be with nobody ain't got no job. That's what I think Chad was weak about, dealing with a woman like that. You don't wife women like that. You fuck them and play them off when you see them in the street.
Well, that's where he met her, and he should have left her right there, because she was on Iyanna Van Zandt. And homegirl worked that Oprah angle with her, you know, oh, poor baby. Now, they think everybody is stupid because most people that watch that show has seen her throw that champagne bottle at that gal just about, you know, telling her who she really was. Yeah. And she, you know, she raised up and said, child, it's going to be all right. This is your daddy's fault and all of that. But some of us know how that played out. She got in his space.
Yeah.
There's the law and then there's a man's law. As men, I can't get so close to you before that alarm goes off. And she invaded his space, and out of instinct and reflex, he backed her up. It just happened that it did some damage, you know.
Yeah, man. Oldest old girl, in my opinion, her history makes her guilty anyway, if you're asking me or you're asking anybody who I feel is going to be real about it, because she used to fuck with Antoine Walker, and I know motherfuckers used to be over the crib with her, and I ain't going to repeat what they said, but I'm just saying, old girl got issues.
And that's why he broke right now.
Yeah. Oh, they got another call? See, we getting calls.
I hope I talked to Otis. Yeah, talk to that.
Thanks for calling,
brother.
This is Jay Nasty.
What's good? It's Jay Nasty.
What's up, man? Shit.
Chill, brother. Man, look, I just want to say, goddamn, I'm happy to hear from you again. I'm glad you got that monkey from the whatever hole off your back, brother. I really do appreciate that.
I didn't hear it. What is it? I missed it. Say it again, Jay Nasty. I missed it.
Hey, it is what it is. But look, hey, with the Chad Ochocinco shit, man, I don't believe that my dude did what he did, but even if he did, well, the bitch really deserved it. Exactly what you said. She always running up. She got that big mouth. She ran up on the wrong motherfucker, and she got that forehead. It is what it is.
I know, man. And you know what I'm saying? It's like, this is what's really the tragedy. You never hear that side of the story on the news or in any of these media outlets. You're going to have somebody like, who you say, Oprah, the Van Zandt bitch, who right. lost her mind and left Oprah. Right. We ain't going to get into what that bitch did. We know that bitch crazy than a motherfucker. This bitch left a hand to feed her and put a perm in her head to go to another show. You always hear their point of view. You never hear the point of view of men who know, obviously, what happened. So, yeah, that's what we on air for, to speak on it. This is what the fuck it is.
That seed was planted on that other show, the NBA wise, even though none of them was married to, you know, player, when they discussed their relationship, and he said, she told him, if we get married or stay together and you're going to cheat, use some rubbers. Then when she found a box of them, now all of a sudden it's an issue.
Well, we all know when those women are on those shows, they fronting for the camera. All that stuff it's a camera in front of them. They fronting for the camera. None of them bitches going to stand on none of the shit they said because they're all whores. NBA whores. A lot of them women were married because they were whoring around on the dude they was with. I ain't going to even say the name. You was cheating on a motherfucker you was with. Then you wind up marrying the NBA player. Now you left the NBA player because you a whore. You a whore.
And he ran out of money.
Whoever you are. All of them ain't run out of money.
Yeah. What's his name? Walker did. Antonio, what's DMV?
Shit, everybody don't want to say their motherfucking name. Well, this
she
street,
got it right there.
It's the street side of the show. Antonio DMV. He probably don't want to say his last name.
I ain't speak on it, man.
DMV, nigga, what up?
Hey, what's happening, Corey? The DMV is D.C., Maryland, Virginia area. Man.
Oh, that's what's up. That's all what's right. up. All right.
Say hello to Melville for me.
I tell you, I agree with you on real quick on the Evelyn and Chad situation. Broad like that, you use the 3Fs on them. You find them, fuck them, and flee them. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you, sir.
And, you know, with her, I mean, he already knew that Broad was, you know, nutty in a pile of squirrel shit. You know, it's just, he basically, you know, brought it on himself, you know, messing with a bitch like that.
You know what I think, so, Antonio? A lot of these niggas, especially niggas who got money, they forget that they just a regular nigga like everybody else, and they think they can save a bitch.
Exactly. You know what I mean? I mean, something like a woman like that, you know, I don't give a damn if you wear your cape 24/7. You everybody can't be saved out here in these streets, you know.
That's right, man.
So, you know, but real quick though, I was watching the special, a documentary they had on ESPN tonight called Broke, about athletes basically fucking off their money and how they end up and whatnot. And a lot of people I saw, like, on Twitter were talking about it, and they were just surprised and shocked about the levels of dumbness that these guys got to as far as with their money and how they lose it. And it's amazing to see how people are so shocked, but just like you said, athletes are still regular people at the end of the day. They still got bills to pay, you know what I'm saying? They still got scandalous hoes in their life. They still got greedy-ass family members and shit. And just because you got a couple of extra zeros in your bank account don't make you any better than anybody else.
Man, that's what's up, man. You know what? And this is what I would say coming from experience. The average person, if you give them $1 million, next year, they will have $1,000.
If that much.
Right.
If that much.
They probably got the $1,000 because they're going to be able to sell the fur they bought to somebody who wanted it.
Maybe.
If you haven't been taught to handle money,
it's over.
And what happens with these guys, by the time they get their hands on their money, there is a certain percentage of the money that is gone.
That's right.
You know, it's like, let's say an athlete gets a deal where he makes, I'm just saying, like $20 million. If the American public knew how much of that money that he was going to be able to put in his bank, you know, that's another thing that will open their eyes to see. It's like these guys have money just to floss. They don't have money to really do nothing with. And if they was to try to do something with the money that they do have, you know what I'm saying? They have to be taught the business sense of money. And nobody really takes that class.
That's right.
You just listen to what these people say. Hey, here's your agent. Here's your money manager. Here's so and so. So everybody's gonna rob you when you got money.
And they're already in place because they was waiting on you when you was in Pop Warner.
Yeah.
Okay, they already, the insurance guy, the real estate guy, everybody's already in play.
And if you got a pussy fetish, it's really over. Because that's the rest of your money right there. They might as well call women the rest of your money.
It's over. It's over.
It's like a guy said, you know, with Shaq making the money that he was making. Shaq is rich. The motherfucker who was writing Shaq's checks is wealthy. That's the motherfucker you should be trying to be.
Yeah, and a guy like Shaq is pretty business-minded. Shaq knows what he's doing. I don't think you'll see Shaq on Skid Row. And it's not like he made so much money more than everybody else, because I think one of the guys who made the most money in the NBA is Antoine Walker.
$110 million he ran through.
And that's not even an Adidas deal.
No.
You know what I mean? But he was married to that bitch who Chad Ochocinco forehead.
But see, you know, what happens is it's not so much the marriage. It's like you start making bad decisions when you're not in balance emotionally. So the woman got you off balance, and now it triggers a whole lot of bad decisions. And it just gets worse. It turns into an avalanche. And one thing, without having to become a Christian, you can really say is true. A fool and his money, they end up going opposite directions.
Yeah, all day long. I haven't watched the thing, Broke, but I'm definitely going to watch it tonight when I get home.
Oh, it's all of that. Thanks for the call. And if you want to get in on this, the number is 323-965-1600. Let's hear from you.
All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be back. The bootleg version of the 5150 show coming back to you in a minute.
Let's hear from some old folks. Who do that song?
Who do that song? I don't know. Who did that song? That's
really?
Jay-Z?
Yeah.
Yo, Jay-Z, what up, yo? No, anyway. 5150 show back. First return from break here at RMC.
Miracles do happen.
Radio, rmconair.com. Go to Lil Pussy's website, check us out. Mm. God damn it, we trying to get it cracking up in the We, you know, it's like the callers have been, I like the fact that the callers talk about what they want to talk about. Even though we started with the subject of Barack, it's really not a subject.
It's related. All that's related. You know.
Yeah.
It's related.
You did some research, Bobby, about, you know, I don't know if we should go into that right now because we got callers on the queue.
Let's see what they talking about. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, well, yeah. We'll
see what they got to say. Yeah.
Hold on. We're going to see what this one dude got to say before we go into this other thing because we don't.
Like the OJ say, you got to get the people.
And on top of that, I remember we used to do the 5150 show. Sometimes people have to wait a long time.
Yeah.
I don't like that. So I want people who call in to feel like they can get through. So
right,
we got KC from
Shakar.
Kansas City. Or is that his name, KC Shakar? KC Shakar. Talk to us. What's cracking, man?
Man, what's happening? This is KC Shakar from East Oakland, California.
Oh, that's what's up? He's Oakland.
I thought it was all Oakland.
Man, you know what, man? Words can't describe how much I fuck with y'all, man. How glad I am that you back on the air. You know, peace and blessings to everybody, man. You know, you truly, man, make my work day go a lot quicker. niggas be talking shit about you, man. About all that voting shit, man. But fuck them. I fuck with you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's what's
all
up,
that
man.
Little bullshit about Obama and all that, man. Fuck that. Real niggas gonna do real things, nigga. It don't matter about who's in office.
Right. That's what's up. You know what? That's what needs to be on a t-shirt. Don't matter who on office. Real niggas do real things.
That's it, man.
Exactly.
It.
Bobby, OG Bobby.
Yes, sir.
I hear from you, beautiful Darlene. I know, with the monkey gone, this shit finna be fire. You heard me? Y'all know we finna get into it. So do you. Don't let these pussy niggas hold you. Bring that shit. I done told you already, nigga. You the best since Richard Pryor, nigga. Fuck what these other niggas talk about.
Thank man, you, we respect you for coming like that, man. Cause take one to know one, bro. Yeah.
Hey, man, real recognize real, man. You looking real familiar, as the boy said.
Yeah, that's what's up, man.
Yeah,
we glad you called. Show enthusiasm to what we doing, man. This is what we do it for, man. We need that feedback to know that we on track. I don't expect everybody to like me, by the way. I do this because I know it's a lot of motherfuckers out here who just like the way the establishment is going about things. But it's
hey, man, it's like a motherfuckers anyway, man. Fuck them niggas.
That's what's up. That's what's up, goddamn it. I ain't never met you, and I know I'm talking to a motherfucker I can relate to.
Man, I'll fuck with you, man.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up. Thanks for the call, man.
For real, man. And tell somebody, man, that we're going to, you know, bring truth to power.
Oh, man, it's all good. I'm going to tell somebody, they're going to tell somebody.
All right then, man.
All right.
All right, brother.
To all you doubters out there, I want you to know that there are people who feel like we represent their voice. So for all you intelligent wannabe motherfuckers, what's the name of the guy yesterday who you guys had on the air?
Oh, Jeff Johnson.
Jeff Johnson. I want to wish that brother luck as he pushes. He's a brother who's really animate about pushing Barack as the next president. And he said yesterday that Barack did everything he said he was going to do.
Look at him, man. He still believe in the tooth fairy. Okay. Because here's the bottom line, man. I'm old enough and willing to admit it to remember what happened to Jackie Robinson. All right. Jackie Robinson had to play baseball and take it for the race.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time his career was over with, he had a hair full of white hair and a stroke waiting to happen because that was unnatural for a man to have to let other men treat him like he was an animal. And for us to, 40 years later, have to sit and watch this man take the indignities no president in the history of this country has ever taken, it don't come with the job to say, when you're the president of the United States, they treat you like that until he got in office.
Well, hold on.
Now they got a policeman drinking beer with him after he done pistol whipped Obama's friend for coming home.
Yeah, basically for coming home. And on top of that, the thing about Jackie Robinson, see, Jackie Robinson is not like Obama. Jackie Robinson was a man.
He was a rebel.
He was arguing with all those racists in the stands who were yelling out, calling him monkey and everything. He was like, well, bring your pussy ass on down here. This man, Obama, has been called a liar in the House.
A communist.
Right.
He's a monkey.
They say it to his face, and he has no... Minister Farrakhan said this, I ain't gonna lie. When he said this word, I was like, that's cold. Obama has no testicular fortitude.
It's embarrassing, man.
How do you let people speak to you that way and you think turning the cheek is the thing to do in this critical time in America where we need somebody to stand up and say what is wrong about what is wrong? You know what I mean? It's like, you can't talk to me like that in front of my wife. You can't disrespect me like that just on GP as a man. And I'm supposed to be the president of the United States. Because, you know, when you call him Obama, some people get mad. They be like, right, he's the president. I'm like, oh, okay, President Obama.
Well, tell these other folks that.
Right. How do you allow people to misrepresent you, to disrespect you without having the courage to say something about it?
It's like this debate.
He acts like it's not happening. When that lady was pointing her finger in his
he
face.
He acted like he wasn't there, man.
And for everybody who haven't seen this, go on the internet and Google that picture where that lady got her finger right in his
in
face.
In his nose.
He looked like it wasn't even happening, if you ask me. He looked like he was, oh, I don't want no trouble. Are you serious?
Man, I almost had a stroke watching that, man. I mean, just out of instinct, he's
I would have to hire security after that because the Secret Service don't protect me.
No.
Because if you put your finger in George Bush's face, what do you think going to happen?
You're getting beat down on television, man.
Right. You're getting stomped
out. Beat down. Especially in America.
Yeah.
But that was overseas.
Well, that was in that man country where he threw the shoe at him and they still got at his ass.
Right. But this is in America. This was in Arizona. And she got up in his face and talked to him like he was a child.
Like he was a kid.
And I said, that's just too much.
And if you say something about it, you wrong for that.
They had a reporter that checked him at a press conference. They're like, you didn't answer my question. They're like, you weren't even supposed to be here. How did you get here? He said, no, you need to. He pointed his finger. I said, hold up, man. This has done went too far. All right. Now, being president until he got in office, you respected the office. Forget the politics. You call him Mr. President, all that. They've been calling him Obama, a Muslim.
Well, that's what Bill Maher said. Bill Maher said, I joke about the presidents like George Bush and people like that. He said, but if I'm in their presence, I'm going to be respectful and address them accordingly as Mr. President or whatever, whatever. Not what I look like trying to down talk the president of the United States of America. But people do it And if you're one who speaks on it, because I expect people who are haters to say something about you when you're in a position of power. It's envy. The people are talking about him out of envy. But you can't, as a person that everybody's looking at, because we're all looking at your actions and everything, you can't sit there and act like this is not happening and look away at what's going on.
And Corey knows this to be true. I told Corey, we've been friends for a number of years, Obama came to Des Moines, Iowa when he was still a sitting senator and was thinking about running for president. And he came to meet my auntie. Google Willie Glanton. If there's a single individual that's responsible for him being in the White House, it's my auntie, because she's a historical figure. Seriously.
Oh, yeah?
Seriously. Just Google. You ain't got to take my word, because she's been to the White House with him.
Uh-huh.
Now, here's the deal. He has never acknowledged her, because he can't do that, because they told him, look, you got to go after the middle class. That's all he talks about is the middle class, even though most of us are not middle class. And after the real estate market fell, most of the middle class ain't middle class no more. It's just rich and hustling in this country right now.
Yeah.
And here's the problem I got with that brother, is the fact that he lives in a city where in his own neighborhood, your hometown, based on what you done told me, if he wasn't the president, he couldn't come out of his house, because our children are killing each other at such a rate won't even speak on it.
Where Barack Obama lives is squared off. There's always police out there. It's like there's always it's like that's a secured area. But right outside of where Obama lives, you can't walk up and down that street and expect drama not to come your way. Because in Chicago, the children of lost bitches rule the street.
The children of who?
The children of lost bitches.
They want to go on
TV and say, oh, we got a gang problem in Chicago. No, it's not a gang problem anymore, because I grew up when gang life was at its highest in Chicago, and gangbangers had a little more control about what they was doing. You couldn't shoot up the whole block when Miss Moore was walking down the street. The motherfucking gang chief would be like, what the motherfucker, shut up? Didn't you see Miss Moore over there, motherfucker? Now, the children of lost bitches will shoot Miss Moore. They will shoot their mama and any other motherfucker to do what the fuck they want to do. That's what's going on in Chicago. The children of lost bitches rule the street. That should be a book.
Now, let's upgrade this back to why some of us are upset with him. When he came in office, when he was inaugurated, the Congress and the House of Representatives was controlled by Democrats. He brought Rahm Emanuel, his homeboy, in to ride herd over Nancy Pelosi and that Mormon Harry Reid.
Yeah.
Okay. Instead of them putting their foot on, as you used to say, they were supposed to have a conference and say, look, if y'all don't follow us, we're going to put some dope in your car and some pictures of some little boy, because we got to pass this shit in the first 90 days to do what we said we was going to do. Instead of that, he kissed them Republicans' ass after they done went on television and said, look, we're going to spend the next 4 years getting this nigga out of here. And he went with that, you know, Mother Teresa shit, you know, let's give hope a chance and all that. And they did it. They gave him the finger for 4 years.
You're talking about Barack.
Yeah.
Barack
the first 2 years he was in office, the Democrats controlled the House and the Senate. And they couldn't get shit done because Harry Reid and Nancy Pelosi gave him the finger and said, here's what we're going to do. We're going to push gay rights. We're going to push this middle-of-the-road shit that we want to do. Fuck what you want to do. Because Rahm Emanuel didn't come in there and do like Bush's people did. And like Clinton did. Remember when Clinton was in office? Half the motherfuckers that worked for him ended up dead when they didn't support Clinton. Clinton was a gangster-ass president, man.
Yeah, Clinton bombed the Sudan.
Not only
and
that.
And a lot of black people don't even know that, because all they know is he played a saxophone on our city hall. He cool.
Well, that's all we got out of it was, you know,
I want to say this. I want to say this real quick as we talk. Yeah. My man that came in, and you know, he just jumped right in like that.
The voice of
friend
reason.
Friend of mine, the voice of reason, Zoe
Williams.
Yeah,
thanks for
coming to the inauguration of the Bootleg 5150.
Come on, man. Let's get it.
Chattown in the house.
Let's get it. Chattown in the building.
Me and Bobby are giving points about Barack that we would love people to talk about and say something about if you got something to say about it. Barack Obama, the president of the United States of America.
Wow. I was listening to what you guys are talking about, and listen, Barack Obama represents the kind of black person, black male specifically,
you sure about that?
That America, white America, wants to see. It is a neutered black man, a man without aggression.
Right.
I mean, all we got to do is look at professional sports. David Stern, no braids, no niggerisms, no. We don't want no aggressiveness. We're going to change the dress code. I mean, look at Dez Bryant with the Cowboys. You have a code of conduct in order to play on this team.
He needs
so,
one.
But the point that's being made is, and I'm not saying that he doesn't need one, but there is a natural aggression with black men that intimidates white America.
Well, it's always been that way.
So when you talk about Barack Obama, he knew what he had to do in order to get the gig. That means there can't be any intellectual aggression in you, because that's going to turn off the middle states, the middle America, white America.
They want you to read the cue cards.
Absolutely. But he knew that.
Didn't you see it in his eye when he read that shit when they invaded, was it, who was the guy? Was it Saddam Hussein? Or was
Gaddafi?
No. What the guy that they invaded?
Man, they didn't invade
they
so
invaded
many
it.
People,
they caught him in the little bootleg ass trap he was living in.
Oh, that's Hussein.
Saddam Hussein. Yeah. When they said we got him, you could tell he was shocked. They made him sit through this bullshit and read that shit.
Right.
I was like, did you see this goofy motherfucker? Man.
But I mean, we all know it's a figurehead position.
No, we may know, but a lot of people don't know.
But, you know, most black people, you know, even Barack Obama recognized once he got the seat of power that it wasn't really a seat of power. It's.
You think he realized that after he got the office?
Well, you know, first off, he's a politician. And people believe in politicians like we believe in preachers. No matter how many times they contradict themselves, we still buy into the rhetoric they're selling.
This fool didn't even believe in his preacher. He denounced his preacher.
He had to get out from under him.
Well, I can't go to your church no more. I'm trying to be president.
But again, it's Jeremiah Wright was aggressive, intellectual, and would speak his mind. They say, okay, that will not get you elected. You see, we need a passive black man so we can promote this as the image globally around the world of how black men in America and around the world should be. Now, that's not to say that he's a bad guy. It's just to say they don't want any aggressiveness. This is just speaking. I was listening to you guys outside. When you guys are speaking to how all of these people are just talking all of this madness about it. I've never seen a president more disrespected than Barack Obama, and he's taking it. So the spin on it is, oh, well, he has class. He takes it. And you know, but at the end of the day, there are even some people in his own party, white men, that are saying, okay, now, at some point, you got to stand up and say something back.
Damn, nigga, say something.
He's still out.
So come
on. Hold on. What you said about the trained black man, basically, that's
right.
What I call that guy.
The neutered guy, yeah.
This is what they do with every black person who has the open mic to speak.
Right.
Starting with sports, because those are the guys who have the open mic to speak. They can't say nothing about how they really feel about the game, or it's a fine.
You can't.
So if their fine is money, I guess if Barack says what he really knows is going on, what will they fine him? But I don't have sympathy for that, because you chose to be president of the United States of America.
This is the game of politics.
And I know you're not ignorant. Right. You know what the fuck this is, but this is what you wanted. So as you're there, I'm calling you out.
Right. When I voted for him in 2008, I made no bones about it. I voted for him because he was a black man, and it was historical precedent, a black man this close. I didn't have any delusions of grandeur that he was going to come in and rewrite the Constitution.
Hold on, grandeur. Could you explain that to our listeners that went to the school I went
well,
to?
Well, no, illusions of grandeur, this big, beautiful, hope that he would come in and change something.
Right.
And I knew what he was doing. He was doing something that was historical, that was unprecedented, and that meant a lot to black people all over the world. I didn't expect...
So you voted for him out of sympathy?
I voted for him because I was happy that a black man was that close and had the chance to do it, and then he did it, being the president. But above and beyond him being a symbol, I didn't think he was going to go into the hood and change the price of chicken or, I didn't think he was going to do anything about, reversing regentrification. Because if we look at his record, he extended the Bush tax cuts. He extended the Patriot Act. He did a lot of the same stuff that Bush did before him. I mean,
with the same people.
He promised that Guantanamo Bay was going to get shut down. No, it's not shut down. Oh, we'll give him 4 more years. At the end of the day, he's a politician. He's playing the same game that the white boy plays. Now, the white boy gets called out in political forums, but black people make concessions for him. We got to call him to the floor, too. At the end of the day, we say Mitt Romney is a hypocrite because Mitt Romney helped create Obamacare. Right? Then he comes out and bashes it. Well, wait a minute. He's a politician. They do that. They flip-flop back and forth. But when Barack does it, we got to be able to call Barack out to the floor, too.
The difference when Barack does it is that we look at him and it's a different look than when you look at Mitt Romney, when you look at George Bush, right, when you look at George Clinton. I mean, if this is just me, I can live with this. You expect bullshit when you see those Caucasian men talking.
Right.
But when I look at a black man,
you expect
and
him
you
to come
bold
real.
Enough
right.
to stand up there with your suit on and look into that TV knowing that my mama and all the other people who don't know shit about shit, and that ain't no diss to them, it's just they're the cattle, they're the sheep.
Right.
You leading them astray.
Right.
You telling them bullshit. They ain't smart enough to peep it out. They right. think something wrong with anybody who say something against what he's doing.
Right.
So you know what I'm saying? It's like, you're worse than them to me.
Right, right.
You're worse mm-hmm. than a George Bush. George Bush was born that way.
And he gonna tell you the truth.
How you gonna walk up and down 51st Street in Chicago, act like you trying to help people, and here it is years later, you sitting in the office, we got him, talking that bullshit about I'm like, this motherfucker ain't shit for that. You know what I mean?
Didn't make any
Wait,
difference.
You talking about Osama, right?
Yeah.
When they finally...
What even about him, man?
It blew my mind when they showed him looking into the screen, like he was like, what the fuck? Motherfucker, you from 51st Street. You just seen shit jump off? The fuck is you talking about?
I don't know if anybody out there is familiar with the name Van Jones. Look it up. Google it. Van Jones is a brilliant brother. He wrote a book that was endorsed by Al Gore. This brother is on top of the future of our economy, mm-hmm. the green economy.
Mm-hmm.
He brought the blueprint to the White House.
Mm-hmm.
He was sitting next to the president as an advisor. And when they saw that he stood upright, they went and dug one of them power to the people things he did back when he was younger, and it circled around, and he had to leave the White House. That's the reason why we're having so much trouble right now having employment in this country, because we'll never be able to bring the manufacturing sector back for one simple reason. We can't compete. How are you going to compete
cheap
with
labor.
Two billion people in China who work for 50 cents an hour?
Right.
You
cheap
can't
labor.
Do that. Yeah. But what we can do is harness the new industries,
mm-hmm.
wind, solar,
mm-hmm.
all of that kind of stuff. And we need to retrofit this whole country. Everywhere you go is pothole buildings,
the infrastructure,
energy,
yeah.
and all that.
But that
kind
was
of stuff.
One thing that Obama promised to fix too.
And he ain't been able to do it because
well, according
the banks
to that
took
brother,
over and the oil company. Why is gasoline still $4.50 a gallon? And well, they talking about drill, baby drill. It's 90 goddamn degrees in October in this motherfucker. Get out of here with that bullshit, man.
Well, as far as it go with the banks, that was the first thing Obama stood up for. The banks.
And they got more money than Carter got liver pills.
Yeah, he stood up for the banks, and he stood up to men who prefer to have penises pushed in their rectum. homosexuals. You don't have to call them gay, because then it sounds like you're dissing them. We're just speaking what it is. There are men out here with dick in my booty fetishes.
And he done signed every piece of legislation come across his
There's no such thing as a gay woman. Women who suck pussy are party starters. That's what I always say. they're good. You need them at the party like clowns. And
they
shit
set
like
it
that.
Off.
You know, right. But gay men are the guys that I'm just saying. You know, you're a bad example.
Well, you've really taken the filter off of yourself now, haven't you?
Well, I used to say this at Foxhole. I just used to have people in the back going, no,
oh, my God.
You know who the fuck you got over here talking shit?
Right.
In fairness to that opposite population, they followed the blueprint.
Did you call them opposite population?
That's what
does that mean?
It means that some of us are still holding on to...
It means they fuck oppositely of... normal guy.
Well, it's just like Corey said, man, the room smells different.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Damn.
Can't look him in his eye when he nuts. Either way, you can't look him in the eye when he nuts.
Oh,
you're going to strain your eye.
It's a whole nother, you know, situation, man.
But back on the subject we were saying, we've been talking shit about Barack, and I think anybody with... neutral ears can tell we're just displeased with what the fuck he does as far as it go with the backbone of a man
and how that affects our people. And according to our illustrious host for this evening, it's time for us to pull back for a minute and sell something. Y'all got commercials?
They ain't got shit for sale on this motherfucker yet. We just taking a break just to be doing it.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to take a break. We'll be back.
You got to come now out there, you know, we'll help you out, put some shit out there.
Make you do right, and love will make you do wrong, and make you come home early.
Sometimes.
Stay out all night long.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we back. Love and happiness is missing in America.
Hard to find, man.
Hell no, nah, man. You know what? We got my man Zo out there. The number to call in is 323-965-1600. That is the RMC. What's the rest of that shit? RMCOnAir.com.
Yeah.
323-965-1600 is the number to dial. Please.
Oh, yeah, that sounds smooth. They heard that shit. That's where you call in to talk to niggas and shit.
So what y'all want to talk about out there?
What do you mean out there?
In radio land or internet land or whatever this is, you know.
No, we're going to go to our second topic, which is, in my opinion, a very important topic. I always end the show in controversy where men and women can talk about the problems that exist out there that everybody's scared to talk about. And that is the pressure of performing in bed with new pussy. I want to let every man out there know that when you sleep with a woman for the first time, the pressure is on. Because if you do not perform to a certain level of expectations, she going to talk about you.
It's worse than that. It's over.
Right. She going to talk about you.
You got some paper. It's over.
Back in the day, I remember I got with this girl in Cleveland. And she was, how could I put it like this? Her body and everything was just like bam, bam, bam. And I was overwhelmed by the pussy, so to speak, whereas it was over in about 30 seconds.
That happens.
And I did a show in Cleveland recently, and she was there, and that look was in her eye.
Damn
shit. Right. I was like, damn, that shit was a long-ass time
damn,
ago.
Man.
And she showed up at the show, and that look was in her eye like,
Did you get another chance?
I didn't
didn't want to prove myself to her because it was so long ago, and plus she looked like the economy had got to her. Where, you know, she had to hustle that pussy to survive. Probably wasn't nothing I could do anyway with that motherfucker. But I'm just saying.
Oh my God.
It made me say, you know what? When you fuck up.
It's a wrap.
First impressions go a long way as far as it go with your sexual performance.
Mm. Well, what are some great excuses for that first mess up, that first time? Well, you know, when you make them, you know, when you bust off.
Ladies out there,
are there any excuses that are acceptable?
Well, in my opinion, this is my opinion, and if any of y'all disagree, you can let me know. If a woman has immaculate pussy,
And maybe we can figure out what immaculate pussy is altogether. But if she has immaculate pussy and you fucking her for the first time and you ain't fucked in about 4 or 5 days or more, it's going to be hard to maintain
an erection.
It,
no, you gonna have to maintain. Hold on,
maintain that buffalo blast sauce from running up out you. I tell people, if it's a girl you really like and you know you gonna fuck her, you gotta go fuck somebody before you go fuck her. That way your dick won't be all shocked when it's getting some good shit. Your dick be like, we just left some pussy, but fuck it, come on with it. I'm just saying.
That's interesting, man. Because so, there's the other thing too, like if you that hot for her. And it take 2 or 3 hours, you know, you got to go through the church thing, and I don't usually do this shit, you know, and you was already on your edge, right?
All the bullshit conversation, right. The pre-fuck conversation, while your dick is pulsating inside. Healthy men know what I'm talking about. Men who ain't healthy, they dick ain't moving. Like, that bitch going to have to jumpstart this motherfucker anyway. But I'm just saying, healthy men who still get erections, you know what I'm saying, performing with a woman, I guess maybe we need to try to give people advice on how to last, because good pussy is good pussy.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Yeah. Well, it might help to just go ahead and tell, look, you know, I've been thinking about you for about 2 weeks now, and I came in here ready to do this, you know, so.
That's going to get this off. Know.
Does a rubber help, though? If you have on a condom, will a condom help last longer?
Because it kind of dulls the sensitivity of it all. Yeah.
And you missing
It kills an erection. That means you can't feel nothing with the rubber, huh?
Yeah. I mean,
I ain't with that, man.
You don't wear rubbers, huh?
I try to stay local.
What does that mean?
Regular, you know, people I done been with, man, you know, because if I wear a rubber with them, they wondering if I've been with some strange and shit, you know.
No, okay, so that's a good theory. You stay local, you had the same 2-3 rotation.
You don't rotation.
You ain't got four, goddamn it.
I ain't lying, man. 58, man. I'm trying to make some money now, man. You know,
I get it. No, when your testosterone has gone down a bit, so your urge to
fuck on sight. Motherfucker. It's just my understanding, man. I ain't got all night.
So you think it's in your mind? Is that what you think?
It's in my day. I've been working 18 hours. I ain't got, you know, I can't, you know, be all night fucking with this bitch, man.
But when you're young, you can work 18 hours
and then go handle it.
Go get ready
to
fuck.
It's not testosterone, man.
Well, what do you think is missing?
Well, what is
you think
it?
Your mind time. Just evolved?
No, it's time, man. I ran out of time, man.
Man, it takes. Obviously, what we talking about proves it take 30 seconds to ski. Something is wrong with you, and it's okay to admit it. At 58, we don't expect you to fuck. The girl who fucking you know you ain't going to get up and do it again. It's okay. You don't have to be ashamed.
Do you think you should take maybe?
Man, you need to hold up about that.
You ain't on. So that means you can fuck 2-3 times a night.
I'm just not going to. I ain't got enough time for that, man. Because I ain't getting paid to fuck, man. I gotta go ahead and get the money. Man.
What?
This is amazing that we. This is my man here, but everybody be in denial about certain shit.
It's not no denial, man.
I said he got to get paid to fuck.
Shit, I'm too far behind, man. I'm like, while I'm fucking this, I'm like, how long this shit gonna take? You know, cause I need to go get this money because it's going to come up the next time I get with this bitch. You know?
Wait, let me get this right.
While you're having sex, you thinking about
how long
money?
It's going to take, man. Yeah, shit.
Get it right, Corey.
How long? Wait.
Catch up, motherfucker. When you get here, you'll know what I'm talking about.
God damn.
He just said when he's fucking, he's thinking about how long it's going to take. So
right.
Are you saying it's up to the woman how long it's going to take?
No, it's up to me. It's just I got to, you know, see where we are, you know, because if I hit this right, I'm going to be able to get some more of it, but I just want to know how long it's going to take.
How long it's going to take?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still a little lost because I know how long it's going to take.
You're a lot younger, motherfucker. Shit.
I know how long it's going to take when I'm up in there. After about the third pump, I can give a bitch an estimate of how many more pumps I got left in this motherfucker. Some girls, you be like, bitch, I'm gonna fuck you all night with this dead ass bitch. But then there's other girls, you be like, baby, look, pass me that coat over there. I'm gonna wipe this shit somewhere. This pussy is amazing. So we got a caller. We got a caller we trying to get in, and maybe he can give some opinion about
speak on it, man.
Lasting in pussy. This is a serious subject. You can lose
pussy.
Your woman behind this.
Good pussy.
Lasting in pussy.
Right.
Who's the caller?
Mike.
Mike, what's cracking? Mike, talk to us.
Hey, what's going on, Corey? What's going on, OG Player? What's going on, Soap?
What up, Mike?
Shoot, nah, I got this story I got to tell y'all, man. All right, you know what I'm saying? I don't look that great. You know, I'm a high average nigga, you know?
I feel that's real.
I fuck girls. I fuck 4s, 5s, and 6s. You know what I'm saying? Nothing too fine, just average enough just to get some, right?
I mean, he fucked 3s, 4s, and 5s, but go ahead.
Twos and fews.
Yeah. Corey, you know, you did that little special about women that, you know, yeah. I fuck around that area.
Yeah.
So, well, I was at this club, and I don't know how, but I landed a 10. To this day, I cannot explain how I did it, but I just did.
Now, do you know what a 10 is, sir?
Okay, yeah. Give us your idea of a 10.
Because a 10, that's as high as it goes.
Yeah, that's the ceiling.
Okay. She's yellow bone. She got an ass. She had a booty. You know what I'm saying? Just looked nice. I can't even, like, I don't even know how I did it.
Were you with David Justice, sir?
No,
I'm just fucking with you.
I'm just fucking with you.
But no, but like, well, when I'm I took her home, go I ahead. Couldn't even tip her.
Cause David Justice?
Bitches, you know?
You couldn't even, you were overwhelmed by her beauty that you couldn't fuck her? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, okay. Just see it like a football team. I'm used to, you know what I'm saying, preseason bitches. I wasn't used to fucking Super Bowl bitches, you know?
Right, I feel you.
So her beauty made you insecure?
No, I don't know.
Shot and you were still insecure?
Nah, she even threw it at me, and so the whole time I was just going down on her, whatever, you know. But right. I don't know what it was.
After a while, she was like, "How much pussy can you eat? Now, what you gonna do, motherfucker?" But look, let me give you some advice, brother, because a lot of men are ashamed to do this. Viagra is not a healthy drug. A lot of people overdose on the shit. But when you are trying to borrow some money or fuck a bad bitch. you might want to pop a blue pill.
Take your chances.
Everybody needs some assistance every once in a while. When you're in the emergency room and your life is on the line, right. That thing they do where they be like, clear. That's some fucking major shit to happen to your body, but they do it because you need it. It's an emergency. We got to shock this motherfucker back to life.
Right.
That's what happened to your dick, sir. You need to apply some shock to your dick. And Viagra is not hard to get, but that shit expensive than a motherfucker. The average pill costs about $20-something, but you might need to buy one pill and just have that motherfucker for that magic moment. Because if she was a 10.
So you mean first impression fucks.
First impression fucks.
Deserve, you know, extra measures. Not only Cialis she, or yeah. something like that.
If you know that your dick don't pop up like that. You know what I mean? You might be on medication.
That's ingenious.
This brother sounds like he's a little older. He might be on medication. There's a lot of brothers on medication.
But that would that be kind of like lying on your dick? You take the pill, you blast her out of her mind, and then you go back to normal afterwards.
That ain't happening, bro. You ain't raised the bar like that.
I'm just saying.
Ain't do that.
So that's a good point you're making. But I want to say this. It's what it's called is not giving her all the information she need. So if you fuck again, if she allow you to fuck again, you supposed to take the pill in front of her. Because she going to ask you, what was that blue diamond you just put in your mouth? And you have to explain to her, look, I want you to get this dick up in you. And in order to pull this off, you saw I just took this motherfucker. I need about 30 more minutes and a jump rope to get this motherfucker to go through my body the way it's supposed to go. You know what I'm saying? So
what the
this is the truth. So have you ever taken Viagra?
No.
Okay. Bobby, have you ever taken Viagra?
One time. It scared me to death, man.
Oh, what was the side effects?
Heart palpitations and an erection at the wrong time. Because, see, that shit kicks off when you're ready to go or not, you know. Yeah.
Your dick was hard by yourself?
Just is that gay? Times in
woke up in a casket. Like
That shit don't got fuck about eroticism or emotion or nothing. That shit has got one purpose, and that's to gas your ass up. And if she ain't there, it's a state of emergency.
It gives me a headache. That's the problem with Viagra I have.
No, they got more problem than that.
I got to take a Viagra and an Excedrin at the same motherfucking time.
I like living.
Vicetacin. They need to put Excedrin in the Viagra pill and call it Vicetacin.
I heard that stuff can make you go blind if you take too much of it.
There's a lot of problems with this shit, man.
If you take it too much, see, a lot of guys feel like they got to take it every time they fuck. No, this is emergency break glass. They should come with a little emergency break glass container.
Wow.
Viagra, you take it when you need to perform, just like FedEx. A lot of shit ain't got to be there overnight. You just send it regular 3-day mail or something like that. But when that shit got to be there overnight,
you go FedEx.
You spend that $45, $50, don't you? Same thing.
That
you got
sense.
You got a dime you done pulled out the club, and this bitch ain't asking for no money, you got to perform.
Well, you need to leave that goddamn poke alone. That's one goddamn thing.
What is poke?
What is that?
Pork. P-O-R-K.
Is that what you're trying to say? Pork.
See, oh.
Yeah. You said poke.
That's where I'm from, man. He knew it. The chat knew what I'm talking
so
about.
So pork, does pork interfere with erections? Do we have any internet findings that may that will validate what Bobby said, pork interferes right.
How
with
How to Eat to Live by Elijah Muhammad.
Does he say pork fuck with your erection?
Well, he just says it fucks
and
with your
overall
health.
All that other shit, you know, the niggas be frying and eating and stuff, man, and then they
so
get
you on saying
on
the 4th of July, don't no bitches get fucked right?
Well, they do, but the nigga died or had a stroke.
On the 4th of July. You know?
Yeah, more pork is consumed on the 4th of July in this country.
And most strokes are had there.
Yeah, I get it. Geez. If pork is a problem, pork is a problem.
It really is.
You know what I'm saying?
This shit done went crazy.
We're trying to save lives up in this motherfucker. Niggas be dying trying to get a piece of ass, man.
People are out there listening.
Oh,
and this is
shit.
Not the type of subject that everybody like to talk about, not being able to fuck when it's time to fuck.
But right. They end up going to these folks' funerals.
And on top of that, we're talking about nutting quick. Nothing quick is something that
erectile dysfunction. Yeah,
is that it erectile really dysfunction?
ED.
It's some punk
or premature ejaculation is what you're talking about.
Premature ejaculation, right? That's right. When you skeet fast. Is she on the phone?
Darlene.
Hell no. We got
wait a minute,
Darlene.
You lying bastard!
No, you don't embarrass me.
We got Darlene on the phone.
No,
Darlene, what did I lie about?
Nothing, cause shit, it's been some guys got naked.
Let her talk, motherfucker. Shut the fuck up. Whatever, Darlene.
In the beginning of the show, you bastard!
What?
Everybody's going, where's Darlene at, Court? Oh, you know, she had to do something else because, you know, the show was off air or whatever it is you said. I was like, son of a...
You done
Darlene,
threw
it's
Darlene
okay. You
got
to pay your bills. You had to put your work in out there.
Look, Corey, late in the fifth, he done hit me up yesterday, gave me a message. Late? How the hell you going to hit me up last night talking about the show tomorrow, Tuesday, 9:30, 11:30? Is that too late for you? No other details. What the hell is that?
Hey, goddammit, this Hollywood. You got to step the fuck up. The roll calls, goddammit. Y'all got colors on DVD in this motherfucker?
Colors.
Hollywood, you over there in Blackwood. Dude, this ain't Hollywood. Hollywood, they at least give you the info. Shit.
Blackwood, ain't nothing wrong with Blackwood.
Right, no, Darlene.
Well, look,
Darlene, what I'm saying is, first of all, you said you had to go to sleep or something, didn't you? You woke up for this shit. What dude left?
Oh, very funny. Who said that, Bobby?
Oh no, I'm Darlene.
Bobby right there. Hey, Darlene.
Do Bobby.
I'm trying to keep hope alive, Darlene.
Exactly.
I ain't gonna start no shit with you this evening.
Okay.
Exactly. What are you doing right now, Darlene? Are you at home? Are you in?
Yes, I'm in the bathroom. I'm just about to get in the shower.
Ah, even.
So is that your way of letting us know that you have no clothes on?
I have a robe on, Corey. Nasty ass.
What's under the robe?
We already know.
Zoe wants to know what's under the robe.
Use your imagination.
I will not.
Do you have colors under the robe?
Oh, God.
Yeah, what?
Colors. Caller.
Oh, there you go, Corey.
We ain't got no music queued up. We didn't know you was going to call.
Y'all just go and take your blue pills, Corey, because you know you need them. That's all good.
That's okay. We ain't shame.
Exactly. Gone.
Especially.
Look, on the next show, will you have your loose talk about bullshit prepared?
Well, yeah, if I know I'm going to be on this dang thing. Look at you.
What do you mean, know you're going to be on? You're on the show. What are you talking about?
I had to call in people, fans from the 5150 show, the old ass show, calling me up, talking about, where you at? I'm like, damn, Corey didn't give me the info in time.
Why are you playing it off, Darlene? Look,
she making it seem like you just ditched her.
Corey, don't be trying to clean it up. You know the truth.
When we did the old 5150 show, the show would be over around about 9 o'clock.
Right.
This show is starting at 9:30 on the Pacific time.
Mm-hmm.
Why couldn't you be here, Darlene? What the fuck?
Corey, you let me know yesterday. Can I replay? If I could replay.
So are you saying he let you know 24 hours in advance?
No, let me tell you what's really going on.
It's not 24 hours in advance. Zoe, he left a message. This is exactly what the message said. We're going to do it on Tuesday, 9:30 to 11:30. Is that too late for you? Let me know. No date, no start time, no place, no address. What the hell?
Oh, so you didn't give her all the information.
Hey, she know where this shit at. She told me. She was like, I think Portis them doing
Corey,
some bullshit
the
down there at that one place by Roscoe.
he done threw your ass under the bus now.
Okay, y'all need to put that cheap-ass beer away, Corey. It's a second.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I'm coming in there next week, and I'm bringing Patron. Don't even play. That's
you bringing
beer.
Who?
What?
Who you bringing? Patron.
Oh, Patron.
Oh, Patron. Okay. You don't drink during the week, Darlene. Darlene drinks on the weekend.
Tuesday is my best available night because I don't have to go to work until the afternoon and the night on Wednesday.
Okay.
Oh. So I'm good.
We miss you, Darlene.
So can we get a twit peek or something? Like take a picture of yourself and kind of...
Yeah, take a picture of yourself because if you ask me, that's really what happened. Women, like, she knows this is going to be on camera. Like, I know it's going to be on camera, but I'm looking raggedy than a motherfucker. I don't give a fuck. I'm a dude. Goddamn it. You going to fuck with me or you not going to fuck with me?
Right.
But see,
yeah, but
women
not, dude,
like
Corey,
to
I'm
get...
I'm not just sending no photos like that. Y'all crazy. See, you're
man,
so
say no nude guys, photos. We said send a photo of how you are right now with your robe on, and I bet you that will explain why you ain't here.
Right. All of the monkey bites will be exposed.
Boy, your guys' minds stay in the gutter. Anyway, I'm going to go, but I just wanted to call in and say...
Oh, when the conversation gets
okay,
real.
Okay, before you go, can you help us? Can you help us? Because we had a topic going.
This.
Darlene, if a guy has sex with you and he has,
premature ejaculation. He's so excited because the yogurt box is so good that he just busses off real quick.
In a minute or less... what do you have to say to men like that?
Well, see, the first thing is what Hazel said, it's so good. It has nothing to do with it just being so good. They probably already have that problem. Premature ejaculation. So it has nothing to do, Corey, with, oh, the girl was so bomb. You have that problem, you just have that problem.
Okay.
You're going to do it regardless. The girl's hot or not. You're going to bust off. Way before time. It's a problem.
I don't know.
I'm listening to her. See, this is why I brought up this subject, Zoe.
Yeah.
Because women think there's something wrong with you. It's just like she's saying. She thinks you do that all the time.
The she thinks
you nut quick all the time if you nut quick with them.
Right.
No, it's actually sad because it's a medical condition.
No, but it's not a medical condition for every dude that busts off quick.
Right.
He just came out of a slump.
yeah. Everybody, you
anyway,
know what?
All right. Y'all look good, man. Y'all look good.
All right, darling. All
right. Are you watching it?
Do
too?
The world a favor and make sure that water hot in a mug.
I was listening to my spin class playlist, and then when I saw it pop up, a fan had hit me up with the info, so I went right on it and I looked at it. I can see y'all. That's why I'm like, put the beard down, Corey.
While you in that shower, we want you to stop up the tub and put some Lysol in the bottom of the tub so your feet can get tended to as needed.
Oh, my. Yeah, you know, maybe stay on the beard, Corey. That helps.
So her feet can get tended to.
Stupid.
Anyway, thanks for calling in, Darlene.
Oh, all right. Shit. Peace, you guys. Good night.
All right, take a bath. The number to call in is 323-965-1600.
Oh, Jesus.
Y'all never give me credit for this, but I'm telling you, that's why I asked her to give her point of view on that. Women think that something is wrong with you
right.
when you nut quick.
Right.
They don't understand it was just, I nutted quick with you. Hold on, here go OG Paul. Let's go ahead.
Or they think it's something wrong with them.
Or they think it's something wrong with them.
If a dude don't get hard.
Or if a dude don't get hard. Oh, yeah. No, ain't nothing wrong with you. If a dude don't get hard, he going through some things. Now, if you get with a dude and he don't get hard again, that motherfucker dick broke. I mean, when I was a young man, the first time it happened to me, and there was this girl, I wanted to fuck her so bad because she, you know, she had broke up with this dude that I used to play basketball with all the time. So I really wanted to fuck her. This is that man in me. Just in case he ever said I fouled him hard. What? Nigga, I'm fucking your man. You know how that shit goes. Well, my dick wouldn't get hard with the girl. I couldn't believe it was the first time it ever happened in my life. I was like, what the fuck is wrong? And she was just looking like,
Man, it's really,
that's that worst. That's that. Oh my God. No, this motherfucker.
Okay, so I got a question. And this is for ladies or any females that are listening, 323-965-1600. How many opportunities does a guy really have to get that premature ejaculation off before you really know that it's a problem? Because I think once, I mean, even with my baby mama, the first time I was with her, it was good. I just bust off. I think I had a good 4 strokes, and I was,
Yeah, see, that shit happens. I love to hear stories like that.
But she gave me a chance. Right. She gave me a chance.
You got 14 more in, huh?
Damn it, I wish she wouldn't have given me a chance, because I hate her right now.
But, oh, yeah, that's the one you have your child by that you can't stand. Right. Right.
It's that one. Yeah.
Funky bitch. My daughter mama, I hate that bitch. Oh, I hope that bitch died for real.
Maybe that was God saying, bust off, and maybe she'll hate you and not give you another chance.
Nothing to do with that shit. Yeah.
What?
That's your goddamn urge to merge.
Ain't nothing you can do about it, huh?
Yeah, man, it's just in us, man.
When you want to skeet, you want to skeet.
When you want to skeet, you
we worry about the consequences later.
That's fucked up, too, it man. Is, when man. I think God about how damn. I think of some of the bitches I fucked ooh, in this world man. That I know I shouldn't have never the went minute, near.
Have you ever had an experience the minute that you had your satisfaction and you like, what am I going to do now?
Right.
Because reality starts sitting in. We ain't got nothing in common. She want to watch Oprah. I'm trying to get Sports Center on and shit, man. We,
I fucked up and fucked this bitch that work at the mall by my house. And I was trying to get that bitch fired before I run into the bitch at the mall one day. And I ran into the bitch at the mall. And I knew this was going to be an emotional type of bitch who needed some type of attention from me.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't feed into that shit. I got the fuck away from her when I saw her. And she was like, oh, Corey! I was like, oh, I got to check this bitch right now, goddammit. But I knew that shit was going to happen when I saw her. This bitch wanted some type of, what's the word? I'm looking for validation by me speaking to her. You know what I'm saying? And I wouldn't speak to her because I ain't called you since I fucked you. The fuck you want to say hi now for? I'm a smart person to catch on, right?
Right, right, right.
Bitch, you work at the mall. You sell blouses that costs less than $10. That store. Everybody know that store.
I was about to say, what store is that?
Everybody that account know that store.
Oh, my God.
It ain't a product in there over $10. How much money can the store make, bitch?
Was that really the problem, though?
What?
Where she worked at?
Or
was
that
some
close
other issue?
When you know, when you have sex with women that are close to you, that's normally a problem. Close to where you live, them close proximity bitches.
Why is it a problem?
Because you run into them.
Too much. And I got it.
A woman that you're not trying to be with.
Oh, that's the bigger issue right there. You
running into them.
Trying to be with her, man.
Mm.
Yeah, who are you trying to be with?
That's the great question.
Most relationships happen because you didn't have a lot of options at the time you was fucking her, and you wind up fucking her more than you would have fucked if you had more options, so that's how you wind up getting to know her.
Man, you just struck a nerve with Jay Nasty, and you just happened to be coming to his town.
Yeah, I'm coming weekend to St. Louis this weekend at the Funny Bone. Man. Jay Nasty, what's cracking?
What it do? I'm going to let you know, man. Jay Nasty speaking. Hey, I bust off, nigga. I jack my own dick, goddamn, about 7-8 times a day.
Damn.
And goddamn me, my nigga, as far as busting off before you get with a bitch, it is what it is. And when you just get off, when you meet a new hoe, you bust off in that bitch, and goddamn me, you come quick. You just be like, shit, well, bitch, goddamn, hey, shit happens. You know what I'm saying? But then you just keep on, like, give me 5 more minutes, suck me back up, and get it off again.
That you know what, Jay Nasty, that's a good point. Why are so
what
many
is
men
going on?
Why are so many men scared to tell the woman to suck me back up? They don't. Sometimes the woman don't know that that's a way to get the dick hard again.
Yeah.
You should tell the bitch, suck me back up. Give me about 10 minutes, drink this beer, watch a couple of highlights.
And shut the fuck up.
Right,
and
suck me up.
Now, sometimes they can just be quiet, man, because when you get to a certain age, you just need a moment.
Are you saying complaining makes the dick soft? A woman complaining?
Ain't nothing kill a dick faster than a nagging ass bitch.
323-965-1600.
Well,
please call
age
in,
will
let
kill
us know
a dick faster.
No, nagging, man. Well, you're right, because when you're younger, you don't hear shit. No way.
You,
right,
that
right
bitch can be throwing a rock at you and you can fuck the bitch when you're young. Age kill erections, Bobby. Trust me.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm going to tell you what's winning for a motherfucker that ain't on medication, man. You just be honest enough, say, look, if you like fucking as much as I do, that's what I'm here for. Here's how we're going to get this accomplished. You know, I'm going to give what I get. Give me 10 minutes after this first one. And if my back ain't bothering me, you know.
That bitch ain't going to never fuck you again. You understand?
If my back ain't bothering me, it's going to shut the whole get down.
If, Bobby, if you say that to a woman and yeah. she fuck you again, yeah, that bitch.
I got some witnesses that are bad testimony.
If that's I ain't a, in the infirmary.
Yeah. Well, okay, y'all just don't understand yet.
When
y'all
you say that to a woman, what Bobby just said, and she fuck you again after that. That bitch is the bottom barrel of the bitches in the city you live in.
She need a rent paid.
See, y'all laughing and shit while I got friends with insurance and shit, man. You
what, what that got to do with anything?
Y'all just said they bottom bitches. They ain't no bottom bitches. Man, these bitches got jobs and insurance, benefits.
Oh, we believe that they the bitches who've been on their job for 30 or 40 years. Shit. But as far as it go with looks, taking them out.
They ain't ugly neither, man. You be surprised. Look at me. You can go across that street right now and see all
kinds. So you're telling me it's a bitch with options going to let you come in there with
you
a back problem.
I'm going to tell you what. You know what
and call you back
you know,
again.
You know what the options are? Either go visit that nigga in the penitentiary and wish that he was out.
Oh, shit.
Try to go with that boy on that billboard over on Crenshaw. She got better chances with me, man.
Hey, man, Bobby, let me tell you.
I'm being honest with you, man. It's rough out here for these women, man.
Please call us, 323-965-1600.
You know I talk shit about the ladies, but if a motherfucker coming there talking about
his back and
my back hurt, I might be able to do it again.
No, I'm going to be able to do it again.
But suck me up. Suck me back up.
If you ain't paying for pussy, you fucking the bottom of the barrel of the bitches.
No, it ain't. It's a bigger market out there than you think, Corey. See, I got you're a celebrity, man. You getting that celebrity pussy,
get
but it's
the
a
fuck
it's
out
another,
of here.
It's a little level out there, man. There's some good looking women, man, that don't want to go with them what they call them guys, them down low motherfuckers, and keep going visiting that nigga at the penitentiary that she ain't gonna be the fuck ever again. So
I get what you're saying with that, Bobby, but what I'm saying
is they got options. It's worse things than a nigga with a that need a 10-minute break, bro.
You my homie, man. You my homie.
It's worse things.
It's worse things
than a nigga who needs a 10-minute break. It's genius.
Another 10-minute. Them 10-minute break motherfuckers ain't getting no pussy either. They
bullshit. Bullshit, man. If you tell that bitch, give me 10 minutes, man. I'm back up in this motherfucker.
You know what? Poetess.
Like this.
Let's ask a woman.
No, fuck that.
Let's get a woman in.
I got to ask Poetess this shit.
Come on, come on.
Because we need a woman's voice with this.
God damn.
When a man say, give you 10 minutes, what the fuck do you think right away?
I give him 10 minutes.
See that? I don't try to tell you.
Bobby! Bobby!
Y'all just ain't been here long enough yet, goddammit.
Bobby said, hey, man. 10
but
minutes.
There was an incident where I went out with a dude and we both had been drinking and he came too quick and I kicked the nigga out. I was mad.
Right.
I didn't give him 10 minutes. I didn't give him 5
Why can't me and just be honest, though? Like, I remember I fucked
this
girl.
And
I lasted about 4 or 5 minutes.
10 minutes.
And she was like, ooh, we going to do it again? I told her, I was like, man, baby, I ain't going to even lie to you. I got a bitch so bad staying around the corner from here. I got to say this last one for when I see her. Because I ain't going to be able to fuck you twice and embarrass myself in front of the bitch I really won't. Don't nobody say shit like that to women.
You'd be amazed, man.
Man, look.
You 10 years out, bro. That shit works, man. I'm telling you, bro. You're going to be pleasantly surprised.
What worked?
Just what you said.
Right, no, I'm saying like, yeah, but I'm work. Not. I don't want the bitch to be waiting 10 minutes because that's pressure.
It
don't
matter. No, it ain't no pressure, goddamn. You done took the pressure off because she already knows. She rubbing on your dick and ain't shit happening. And now she looking at you funny. And I'm like, look here, bitch, you ain't going to put that on me.
Give what do you
me
mean?
10 minutes. Give me 10 minutes.
Wait, how is that not on you?
If, it ain't.
If she rubbing on you.
In 10 minutes, she going to hit that motherfucker. It's going to be like a diamond up in this motherfucker. Give me 10 goddamn. That's not no lie.
If a female hand don't get your dick hard.
She got to wait 10 motherfucking minutes.
Okay, well, if she waits.
This shit is crazy.
No, we talking about this bullshit.
If a female hand.
If a female hand.
Don't get you hard.
And sometimes the hand by itself. If a female wet her hand.
Look at it, man. I'm just telling you what
if
I know.
If she rubbed that part on the bottom of your sack with no hair on
it. When she's trying to look at me like that's my motherfucking fault, I'm going to say, look.
Your dick don't get
off.
When
you started this goddamn shit 2.5 hours ago when it was goddamn on and cracking, and now you going to sweat me about 10 minutes? Give me 10 goddamn minutes.
I never put a time on this shit.
Are you saying women don't give men the proper time they need to recover?
No, men don't ask for it. Is that what you're saying? No, men don't ask for it. Because you know what women do? They look at you, man. And they be like, look, either you going to bullshit me and tell me some of that, I just had a heart attack or some old bullshit, or you just tell the truth. I really like you and give me 10 minutes.
So what's the best way to ask for it? That time you need.
By name. Just tell her, look at me.
I had a gangster bitch. Tell me.
I ain't on no medication. I just need 10 minutes.
Bobby, I had
We're going to play some Luther.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
You know what I mean?
A 10-minute music break.
Right. Yeah, you going to go change outfits and shit?
Intermission.
Yeah.
No, but this is what happened to me.
A sex intermission?
I had this gangster bitch I was fucking.
Hey, y'all keep laughing.
I nutted. The bitch say, look, I need some more dick. Mm. I said, well, you got to give me a little time. She said, well, I need you to eat my pussy again till your dick get hard. I told her, I didn't like eating your pussy. That's going to interfere with my dick getting hard. If you want results, you just need to just be cool. Don't put that pussy near me again. I think that's what's wrong with me now.
Uh-oh.
I think we got a female on the phone. And she from New Orleans, goddamn.
She know about that mojo.
Wet foot.
Damn. Come on, New Orleans.
Corey, I'm going to need you to knock it off with the Katrina jump. This is insane, dude.
Girl's feet still wet out there.
You are so crazy. It's been 7 years, dude.
Oh, my God. Okay.
This is what I wanted to say. Like, I thought your time slot was, like, so late, but you all are right. Time slot, because I don't remember 5150 being this vulgar. Y'all are off the chain up and down.
Well, we are, this is the first show, and we formatting the shit and getting it right. So y'all bear with us, goddammit, but we going to talk this shit regardless.
Now, I ain't tripping on it. It's been so long since I heard you, you know, on the mic. I'm just like, I don't remember even Bobby wilding out. I'm saying, I just don't remember y'all being this off the chain.
And with that being said, let me ask you a question. If a dude dick won't get hard because he's fucking in the Superdome in front of everybody, will you hold that against him?
Oh, just, my God.
Just say he's embarrassed because everybody's in there watching.
They ain't watching, they're hearing.
I wouldn't be participating in that because I'm in a very committed relationship.
That's great.
I wasn't in the Superdome, so I really can't speak on it.
Where was you at when it was raining all night?
Well, you must know, I evacuated there, Katrina. I was in West Palm Beach, Florida, chilling
on the
beach.
Got a rich nigga.
Oh, yeah, she had
she
way out.
She got a sponsor. Shit. Mad at you, Mona Lisa. Shit.
That's what's up. So yeah. your man ain't got no erection problems or nut quick problems, do he?
No, he don't have those kind of problems.
Wait a minute. He's a man. All men have them at some point.
Well, he probably young.
But do you give him a break?
No, he's never had them with me, so I don't know about before me, but...
Because you from New Orleans. That means your pussy wet.
Corey,
I couldn't resist it. I couldn't resist it.
I still fuck with you, but you need to go to hell tonight.
Okay, hey, I feel you.
Hell.
Hey, I got another question for you, Mona. How long do you think the average sex session should last?
Right.
Well, it don't take me that long, so I say the average in America might be probably like 10 minutes.
In America.
10 minutes, that's all you need.
Damn, you beat the game. Motherfucker, fuck you 10 minutes, goddamn.
And that's all Bobby needs is rest. 10 minutes of rest.
Bobby can take over when he through.
Real quick. I just want to say I'm watching the chat, and I'm figuring if most of these people that's typing all this bullshit on the chat are calling in, the show will really be off the chain. So they need to call in because they wasting their life typing. They need to participate in the show. Huh? So I know y'all hear me in the chat. Y'all need to call in.
That's what's up. We love your voice, too, baby.
Sure enough.
323-965-1600.
Good night,
y'all. All right.
Thanks for calling, Mona. What's that number again, Zoe?
323-965-1600. Was that Toya? It sounded like Toya calling in from the Teeny and Tiny or whatever the television show.
Oh, you talking about old girl, T.I. White.
Is that her name? No, the other one.
That's Tiny.
Yeah, they had a show together, right? They just had that accent. It reminded me of that girl. 323-965-1600. Please call in. More ladies. I like the ladies are telling the truth. The only question we didn't ask her, I wish she would have stayed on. What was her name? Mona. I wish she would have stayed on. Just basically, if her dude asked for a break, how would she feel about that? The 10-minute break. The sex intermission that Bobby is talking about.
I will say this. If a dude asks you for a break while he fucking you, you need to give him a break. He finna die.
No.
Don't no motherfucker ask for breaks unless they really need a break while they fucking.
I have earned that break, man, because if we'd have got started 2 hours ago, this shit wouldn't have been necessary. When you was doing all that, trying to read me some Bible scriptures and tell me about we shouldn't be doing this and all that kind of stuff. Because I was ready then.
I want to watch you fuck, Bobby.
Well, it's going to be what is?
I will pay to watch Bobby fuck.
It's a goddamn show, man.
And then I want to wait for the 10-minute rule see.
It's a beautiful thing.
Oh, God.
It come with some instructions. Go change your outfit.
Okay.
Okay, because I got that Luther. You know.
Luther.
Yeah. What is that?
Luther Vandross, goddammit.
You play Luther while you fucking?
Man, and hit that motherfucker, man, that eyes roll around on motherfucker.
What song
head.
Do you play? Dance with My Father?
Hell no, motherfucker. Shit. Fuck that, man.
What?
If only for one night, motherfucker.
This nigga said dance with my father.
Hey, when Luther came out with that album, I was like, this motherfucker wanna say he like dick in his ass so bad. Just saying, Luther. What the fuck is you saying?
Yeah. It's over now if we're gonna start that kind of goddamn shit. Man.
Yeah. Hey, man, so look, Poet, is this coming up on the 11 o'clock hour?
Yeah.
Well, we got like 30 more minutes, right?
Yeah.
Oh, what's up? Shit, this dude here.
What? Which one, everybody's scared to say something. Man. Bobby is the only one speaking from the heart, but he putting his foot in his mouth.
No, I'm not. I'm speaking for motherfuckers that already got a right to say, look, man, I remember when I was y'all age and I could get away with that shit y'all doing because it came that way. But you get to a point in your life, if a woman like you, if she really like and she done already, you know, gave you that pussy that you know she meant for you to have, you owe it to her to say, look, I'm going to hit that motherfucker where you want it in 10 minutes.
And that should be enough.
And if that don't work, fuck her. It's another motherfucker at the club that's with that.
I think telling a woman I'm going to hit it the way you want it is a bit cocky.
It ain't cocky because you done already done it.
I mean, you've already hit it, but
if you done hit it right, that's why she's still fucking with you. Why you think she fucking you, man?
When you tell a woman you're going to hit it the way you want it, I think you're putting her on the spot.
No, it's not on the spot because
or maybe you're putting yourself
already.
on the spot.
No, ain't nobody on the spot.
You're embarrassing
y'all
yourself.
Y'all act like women don't like fucking. Some of them really do, man.
What if she like dicks in her ass and pussy at the same time?
Then you can't give it to her like she wanted it.
Oh, it looks like the ladies are calling in. 323-965-1600. We got
Chris from where?
That's Chris from Kentucky.
Hello.
Hey, what's going on, y'all?
Hey, is this, what's up, Chris?
I got a little story. I just want to say, I'm a little older. I'm about 37.
You ain't old, you motherfucking shit.
Yeah, this is old-ass Bobby in here, and he got old on lock. You can't come in here claiming you old.
Bobby nutted in a girl at a at a sweetheart dance.
Before he got here. Go ahead, Chris. What's up, man?
At a Little Rascals movie premiere.
As the years went on, you know, my sex drive done went down, but I wanted to give y'all on a product. It's called Vigor. It's Viagra, but it's natural, all natural. So you ain't got to worry about having your dick hard for 6 hours or nothing like that.
What's the side effects?
Nothing. It's all natural. It's just, you know, I don't know what the fuck's in it, but it's an all natural pill. It's like it.
How the fuck you gonna say no side effects if you don't know what's in it?
Who sells it? Mary Kay or somebody?
You voted for Barack, didn't you?
I took it and there's been no side effects for me other than one fuck mo. That's about it.
And you say you 37. Okay. You know what? You need to lay off that goddamn poke, man. Cause, your dick still should be
rock steady at 37, man.
Everybody dick ain't the same.
No, but the research says that
diet, man. I'm telling you, man.
There's some empirical data out there that speaks on the lowered testosterone levels in men of today. They say a 70-year-old man has more testosterone than a 35-year-old man of today. They said the testosterone levels have been currently dropping. That's why there are a lot of products out there to
boost your
testosterone levels.
They act like it's the products. It's when they circumcise your dick. If your dick look good, it don't work good. Them motherfuckers with them elephant trunks, them 70-year-old motherfuckers who mama ain't have insurance, so they dick ain't get cut right.
Hey, thanks for the call, Kentucky.
Fuck all night with that motherfucking...
Oh, we got a girl.
We got Trisha on the phone from Georgia. Come on in here, Sweet Peaches.
That was some old school shit
right there.
I'm going to represent my goddamn generation, man. Shit. Hello, Miss Trisha.
Good evening. How you doing?
I knew she was going to sound like that.
I'm a big fan. I'm listening to you guys on my phone, actually, because my laptop is acting up tonight.
Well, we glad you're listening, Trisha.
For sure. You done made Corey go Barry White on your ass. Come on, Trisha.
Trisha, are you home?
Where are you located currently?
And you got these motherfuckers up in here begging like Benny up in this motherfucker. Come on, Trisha.
I'm at home tonight. I didn't have to work.
Okay.
Ah,
is there a man in bed next to you right now, Trisha?
No, no one's here.
I knew it wasn't because you wouldn't be on the motherfucking phone.
Right.
Unless he was on break.
Unless he had that 10-minute Bobby break.
The Bobby break?
Take a Bobby break. That's going to CC that.
I just wanted to call in tonight and let you guys know to leave him alone because I've had guys to tell me, give me 10 minutes and I'll get you right.
Mm-hmm. And did they get you right?
Yes, they did.
That's why she sound like she's satisfied every now and then.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, can we get a picture?
Oh,
I mean, because it's late and you call in.
Can she send a picture?
I think she
can
send us a picture.
Can she send us a picture? Is there a site where she can send us a picture?
There's Twitter. She can tweet pick it or twit pick it.
Twit pick it to me.
Trisha, you sound like you got some sponsors, girl.
My Twitter is the Corey Holcomb. Twit pick us a picture. Don't be shy.
Right. I'm at Zoe Williams.
The more skin you show, the more prize we going to give you.
Okay, I'm going to keep that in mind.
Right. No, take the picture. Don't think about it.
Oh, my God. Well, you know, she just like Darlene. She got to go get all jazzed up and everything. For a little twit pick. We really don't care about looking at your head. We want to look at the head.
Where you want the picture of, Corey, specifically?
I can't say that on the air because she'll feel like I'm disrespecting her. But
and it's not necessary because this is a Southern Belle. Sometimes.
They need to be rung, too.
Sometimes. Sometimes. Ain't you, Trisha?
See what part of Georgia you in right now, Trisha?
I'm actually in Augusta.
See, she left Atlanta because she ran out of hope.
Yeah, it's a whole lot of it's a whole lot of men with
Hey, Trisha, we're gonna do this every Tuesday night, 9:30 to 11:30, till we can get some better hours. Please call back again.
I definitely will. Thank you, guys. Have a good night.
Thank you so much.
All right, we're gonna get ready to take a break.
Oh, my God.
We'll be back. Bootleg 5150. That's what's up.
Ooh. Shit. She plays the record.
Early dawn warms up to the sun. It would be so nice.
Shit on. If only for. And wash my ear juice. What up? We back.
Yeah.
5150 bootleg version over here. In a dangerous part of town where any place you know where they sell fried chicken and waffles, you in danger.
And for whoever said I look like I'm 72, try to catch up.
Just live a little longer.
Try to catch up.
Okay.
Try to catch up. Bobby taking that shit personal.
No, I ain't taking it personal. I just responding to the public.
That's called taking it personal. That's,
yeah.
Nah, it's personal. God damn it, I ain't no goddamn Android.
Bobby finna check him up.
Chat Town in the building. While you
I'm from Murfreesboro, nigga. You from Chat Town, man.
Murfreesboro.
Oh, where is that?
It's where they fought the Civil War at, for real.
I was just going to say, an old ass town.
Just about got like four people in it right now.
We'll fuck you up by fucking with us. You know?
We got a Pepperidge Farm Remember store in that motherfucker.
We ain't going to start no trouble. We ain't running from none either, though, goddammit. Bet you that.
What kind of store?
They sell Bosco chocolate milk syrup in that motherfucker. That's how old that stuff is.
And ass kickings on demand. How about that?
BC powder. All kind of shit.
And we come back strong right after we take them motherfuckers. Oh, how about that? Yeah, that's right. You got it right.
Said he was an eyewitness.
Free at last, free at last. You know, ain't kissing nobody's ass. How about that?
Ooh, shit! Yeah. Right
if
now,
you look at that picture with Malcolm X's.
Yeah, how about that?
If you look at that picture with Malcolm X speaking his last speech, Bobby in the audience with a tape recorder.
Teach Malcolm. Because y'all thought y'all landed on Plymouth Rock, and Plymouth Rock landed on your black ass. How about that?
Yeah, all right.
That was a good movie. I remember.
So check this out. This evening, we got our list rocks off on Barack, but the main thing we learned this evening, we learned a lot about how women think when men pre-ejaculate.
Yeah, a couple women gave us some jewels on
that. Yeah, some girls say in 10 minutes he really did have it back up. I can't give you no time. Don't put no time on me because I feel like you win it.
It might be fire for you. I don't know. Just tell them what's in your heart, bro.
Well, you're
going to do that anyway, though.
Can I ask you a question, Bobby? Can you give the women out there that are listening to the show some tips on getting a dick back hard? Obviously, sucking a dick will help.
Yeah, that's the number one tip for me.
Not necessarily. The first thing they got to do is allow you to be honest with them, because, and then they got to be honest with you. If they want some dick, then say it like you mean it.
So her like passion can get your dick hard. Yes, is that what you're saying?
Sincerity is important.
The desire to want the dick back up.
Don't lie to Bobby if you want the dick to work.
Right. You know, let me know that you don't want to take
I want it, Bobby.
Yeah. That'll do it, man. That might cut it to 8 minutes. You know what I mean?
Can you give us an example of a female voice pleading for the dick to come back up? Can you please just...
Between begging and pleading. Pleading is, look, I really do want this dick.
Desiring the dick. I'm telling you, poetess has a beautiful voice. Let's hear it.
They really are, man. They're really tired of going through niggas.
Please, poetess.
You have 10 minutes.
Oh, okay. Make it nine. There it is. Man, I might do it in seven. Just on that. I ain't lying, man. Something about that, man. Nigga stand up, you know.
Yeah.
It do, man.
I know when women have, like, older daughters that are in the other room, if you unlock the bedroom door, that make my dick hard, too. I don't want her to have to turn the knob and it don't open. I want her to watch and witness.
See, that's a generational thing. I can't speak on that because I'm not in my 40s, you know, so Corey has another goddamn disposition.
You done fucked a woman with a grown daughter before.
No, I'm from an era where that just didn't go out. It didn't go like that, man.
What happened? You don't fuck women with daughters that are older?
He's from a generation that don't.
Murfreesboro. Man, where they come out and pump your gas for you. You ain't even got to get out your car. Good morning, Mr. Bobby. Want me to fill it up?
Y'all laughing, man, but you know, we had more fun than y'all did.
Oh, yeah?
Hell yeah.
Oh, somebody got to call in on that. 323-965-1600.
You used to play stick and can? Is that what you used to do?
That's why you don't go to club, because it's embarrassing, man. Y'all go to club now and niggas dancing with each other and shit, man.
Well, I will give y'all that. Them sock hops y'all used to throw back in the day was the shit.
Stay in my corner, man. But girl, dance you off of that, man. You're going to find out what time y'all going to do something, man, because she rub you in the center of your back and push that thing up on you. You got permission to ask for some pussy.
Well, let me ask you a question. So, did you ever have
buy no
like,
drinks and shit? Y'all be buying Patron and all that kind of shit, man. They put on a slow record, man, and you find out if you're going to slow dance with you, then you got action.
So back in your
y'all
day,
y'all be buying Patron and shit and some shit I can't even spell.
Bobby is on fire.
No,
right
I'm trying
now.
To find out what he said.
On fire, man. This shit is true, man.
This is past Bobby bedtime. Bobby,
y'all be trying buying drinks.
He took his
and
pills
shit,
and he tried to stay up and shit.
Smacking his shit in, right, in the microphone.
He ain't aware of this shit. We ain't holding this against him.
He ain't remember none of this
so
shit
you
in the
saying
morning.
Back in your time,
see,
Bobby.
Y'all wish, man. You know,
back in your time when a girl would slow dance with you, that
man,
means
you
want to get
man.
With you.
She wouldn't dance with you otherwise. She'd go to the bathroom.
She go buy a Shasta? Is that what you go buy?
Nah, we had a red drink called Knee High back then.
A red drink called Knee High.
We used to ask them, girl, what would you do for a moon pie and a red drink?
Ooh. A moon pie and a red drink.
These people from Murfreesboro, they like, Bobby, tell them, Bobby, Bobby. God damn it.
Show them how the pimp game work out here.
No, the music was, now, if you, a woman dance with you when you say, won't you stay, yeah, stay, darling.
That's the song.
Man, look at here. By that time, that's over with.
Oh,
that old school singing.
It's time to do some cheating in the next room.
Distant lover.
There you go. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Bobby, let's give us an example of what was out when you went on prom. What was they playing and shit?
Let's Get It On.
Let's Get It On, Marvin Gaye. Man, you talk dance. About odds, motherfuckers got problems. Marvin Gaye was singing to your ass.
But I wasn't listening. I wasn't listening, though, man. I wasn't listening.
Is that a caller?
E.T.
E.T. is on the motherfucking phone.
Help us out, man.
Home.
What up with it, man?
What's up, E.T.? What's cracking?
What's up, 5150? Man, I'm going to keep it funky tonight, man. I just came back from the bar. I'm on the East Coast right now. It's 2 in the morning.
Oh, man. That's what's
yeah,
up,
yeah, it's
man.
Late as fuck.
Did you come up?
You missed
yo,
out.
Yo, I'm good, brother. Listen, every real nigga know you got to put a bitch through the Corey Holcomb experiment.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And for any nigga that don't know what the Corey Holcomb experiment is when you take two bitches, you take one bitch, yeah, I mean, you treat her like a queen.
Right.
You treat her like you know what I mean, like the world revolve around her.
Open the car door for her and everything.
All that sucker shit.
Right.
All that sucker shit.
Right.
But the other bitch, you stand on her head in the middle of the street.
You dog that hoe out.
Dog walk that bitch.
Spank her child the day you meet it.
Guess what? At the end of the day, nigga, it's 2:15 right now. I got a bitch coming over in 15. I got a bitch coming over in 15 minutes, and it's the bitch I put my motherfucking foot on. You understand
me? The bitch you
me?
Treat like shit gonna come make sure you straight.
Yes, sir.
The bitch
you
treat like
me?
A queen don't give a fuck about you and what you're going through.
Yes, sir.
This young man know what the fuck he talking about, Bobby.
You got to keep it funky out here, man.
Hey, that's what's man, up, man. You thanks, for, stay.
Thanks for that call. That was a real call right there, brother. E.T., all you guys
but
out there who think you gain positive advancement with a woman by treating her like a queen, you a fool. Even
go deeper. Why is that? Why is it that if you treat the girl with respect and like a queen that, you know, somehow she doesn't respect that or receive that, and if you treat her badly, she wants you more. Why does that happen for the women or for a woman? Why would I still don't get it.
Are you still in rehab or what, man?
No, I'm not in rehab. I don't do drugs.
I ain't talking about drugs. You addicted to nice girls.
Fuck is he talking? Just
you
explain it. I'm trying to set this
I mean,
up
I'm
for
saying,
the listeners.
Like, a lot of women. A lot of women feel like when they're with a man, they have to conquer him. And if you're nice, they feel like you've already been conquered. Mm. But when you're a piece of shit, they in their mind, they're like, I'm going to fix him.
Mm.
I'm going to make him be what I want him to be when it's all over. That's why the girl that the dude E.T. dog out is on her way over there to get her pussy reevaluated.
That's what I wanted you to do is just explain it. That's all.
She gonna drive home with leakage on whatever she got on.
I just want y'all to know that Corey Holcomb is holding out on y'all. Okay, see, there's some female Corey Holcombs out there that just like fucking, and they will ask for dick by name and tell you, "Don't call me tomorrow. I'll call you when I get another break because I got some sponsors."
Mm.
Okay.
Mm.
He done been with him.
True.
I bet you out of all of the callers that's listening, it ain't but maybe about 1% ever heard a woman say some real shit like that. Because that ain't how women talk to motherfuckers.
But you done been with a couple of them bitches and you miss them right now. Because
but
you
they
no
look like they was
going to
say that.
Nah.
All the bitches who say shit like that look like they going to talk like that.
Grow a little older, brother. Grow a little older and keep traveling. God damn it. Keep traveling. I got some photos I'll show you, man. I'm just telling you, Cole, you really have had so much success being famous and from Robert Taylor Holmes that, you know, pussy done fell in your lap. But for those of us who had to go out here hunting and shit, I appreciate them beautiful girls that stepped up and chose me. It might have been the green eyes or whatever the fuck. I'm like,
what proof do you have a beautiful girl stepped up and chose
I'll show you.
You
the picture. I'll show you. I still got the photograph.
I take that as evidence. Where is it at?
They still.
I ain't got them with me. I'll bring them. I'll show them to you next time you see me.
Next show, Bobby is going to have to bring us proof.
I'm going to do that.
That he has had any intermingling.
I'm going to do that. I'm going to do that, goddammit, because you done missed the market that's available, goddammit.
With beautiful bitches.
Yeah, man. They the easiest motherfuckers because they done got tired of these motherfucking pie back ass niggas come up here.
Pie back. That's new. That's some Murfreesboro shit right there.
A pie back ass nigga.
Man, it's a whole market of women out there that is sick and tired of these pussy ass motherfuckers that's leading with their wallet and then they run out of money. Okay. And they on medication.
So you saying that's some new shit, men who lead with their wallet.
They've been doing that since time immemorial. But they going broke faster now. And they on medication. And that's one thing a woman ain't going to tolerate is too many nights where, you know, you can't make the, you know, you can't hit it. You got to hit it. And it's about that 10 minutes. After about 10 minutes. You know, 15? Oh, hell,
you know what?
Nah,
I know I'm responsible. I'm responsible for giving Bobby
yes,
2 beers.
Yes, you are.
Let me tell you something.
You got him up, man.
This is my man right here. When this motherfucker get drunk, he will call me in the middle of the night. He done put bitches on the phone. Corey, this bitch right here. We can tell her what real men do.
You know why? Because
I done hung up on so many of
that.
These bitches.
She needed to hear that because she thought it was just me. You see what I mean? They think we by ourselves because there's so few brothers that's got enough motherfucking truth in them to tell a lady, look, you keep acting to me like I'm strange. I ain't the only motherfucker out here that will tell your motherfucking ass because he going to ask you what the fuck I'm doing calling him. And I need some help because I need 10 minutes, goddammit. You know?
That's right. You the 10-minute brother.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to sum it up with all honesty. Yeah. When it comes to fucking how your pussy is how my dick go. Yeah, if I fuck you a long time, that mean I just came from some pussy or I just jagged off. Something happened for me to last in your
See,
pussy.
See, he ain't been with Betty Joe Johnson yet. God damn it, Betty Joe Johnson will change that nigga disposition.
Who the fuck is Betty Joe Johnson? A bitch with a beard?
Middle name is Joe.
Her father's 6'5", god damn it. Bring him in here, I want to meet him. Oh, man, I ain't going to see that nigga. Ain't the old days.
Betty Joe Johnson. Right. You got a beard.
Right. Speedy looking bitch. Betty Joe Johnson.
Okay. Oh, my goodness.
I'll just catch up, man.
Everybody out there who listening in the St. Louis area, I want y'all motherfuckers to go buy y'all tickets to the St. Louis Funny Bone because I will be there this weekend talking my shit. If you have something to say to your woman or you feel like you need to check her or if you feel like your girl is getting out of pocket, don't argue with her. Just bring her to the St. Louis Funny Bone. Everything you're thinking is what I'm going to deliver to her, okay? Mm-hmm. That's what's going on this weekend, St. Louis Funny Bone. Bobby, what you doing this weekend?
I'm going to Des Moines, Iowa to see Willie Glanton, my auntie. She's 91 years old, and she helped that man in the White House get elected. You ain't got to take my word for it. Google the name Willie Glanton. And I'm gonna promote Real Men Don't Play because I'm glad it's going to be out by the end of the year. And this brother that's sitting to my right, Corey Holcomb, is the evidence that real men do still exist. RealMenDon'tPlay.com. Go there. You ain't got to take my word for a goddamn thing.
That's what's up, Bobby. Zoe, you got something you want to plug right here?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. I just finished the 12th chapter of my second book, finally. It's done. I finished it. I think day before yesterday, I did finish the last transcription, and now it's being edited, and we're looking for a February launch of my second book. So,
what's
really
the name
excited
of
about that.
That's
oh, yeah, and shit, the Zo What Show here, Zo What Morning Show, 11 a.m. Tuesdays. Same day. We got Tuesday unlocked then, don't we, Corey?
What's the name of the book, man?
The name of the book is The Relationship Dismount, How to Break Up Effectively. It's a great book about breakups. Mm. Stick the dismount. Land the dismount cleanly.
And my book, when I get through bullshitting, I'm going to finish it. It's a book for all the women out there who have had a man go out and have a child, you know, out in the street. You know, a lot of women have to deal with that. They find out their man got a baby coming.
Ooh.
And it's called Accepting the Side Baby. a lot of you women out there are mean to the side baby that he bring home.
Accepting the side baby.
Accepting the side baby. It's a lot of little babies out there can't even meet their stepbrothers and sisters because the bitch got a problem with them.
You mean they have brothers and sisters?
They have brothers. Little motherfuckers that came before now.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of guys don't know how to introduce the side baby to the family and stuff like that.
Accepting the side baby. Yeah. It's stupid as shit.
Well, your subtitle should be "What You Do in the Dark Gonna Come Out in the Light."
Yeah. All right. So,
okay.
This was the first 5150 show.
We can't
show.
Let him drink no more, man.
Right,
no,
man, Bobby.
You know what? Y'all can use that bullshit excuse if you want to.
He got a beer and a chicken wing in his hand.
And am I lying? Up right now. Everybody can see the chicken in his hand.
Go to realmendontplay.com and see if I'm bullshitting. All right.
All right.
Fuck these niggas.
Right. That Bobby get when he get drunk. He
I love it.
He juggling high.
I like this every day, and he just put me in that position because he can get away with that.
No, Bobby, this is how he get when he get drunk. But anyway.
Believe me, people, I'm an intelligent brother, and I'm very conscious of what I'm saying, and I mean everything I said. Just go to realmendontplay.com.
When you got
to
say you're intelligent, that means you doubt it. this has been the bootleg version of the 5150 show. We're going to get it together. We're going to get our topics back like we used to have. We're going to be talking shit. You know how it go. We're going to have Darlene up in here throwing off the chemistry of every motherfucking thing. y'all know how it go. All right, so we up out of here. Zoe, thanks for stopping by.
Hey, man, anytime, homie.
OG
anytime.
Porters, thanks for helping
thanks,
us put
Porters.
The bullshit together. So all the little kids out there, you ain't going to make it.
you ain't going to make it.